What's going on, everyone? How you guys all doing today? My name is Matt Jarbo. This is Three Buck Theater. And today we're going to be talking about a weird article that popped up yesterday that I didn't get to because I wasn't feeling very well. But yesterday, Collider did an interview with Ghostbusters 2016 director Paul Feig, to which case this little nugget popped out of it. A 3.5-hour cut of Paul Feig's Ghostbusters exists, saying that Ghostbusters 2016 is one of the most polarizing films of the past 10 years. Yeah, it is. I'd say for the last 5 years, to be honest with you. Originally intended to relaunch the franchise starring an all-female team, right from when the first trailer dropped, there were issues. Internet bloggers and commentators had a field day ripping into the film's tone and mediocre effects, and saved most of the vitriol for the female cast themselves. When it actually hit theaters, it was a modest success, but far from the blockbuster return many were hoping for with the new Ghostbusters film. Director Paul Feig had a chat when it was released with Collider, and where he revealed that that the film was almost much different at release, with a runtime of 3.5 hours. That's right. 3.5 hours of that movie. And now there's talks of release the Feig cut. Release the Ghostbusters Feig cut, whatever you want to call it. I don't know. Now, I'm going to sit here and I'm going to have a very controversial take, but I want you to stay with me. Release the cut. I want to see it. I support it. Now, the reason why I support it is multiple fold, and we're going to dive in. So the number one reason why I support it is because I do support artistic vision. Even if I don't like the artist or ultimately the vision, I do want to see what they come up with without studio interference. I have been very vocal about my support of Zack Snyder's Justice League, and it's one that I very much wanted to see come to fruition for a long, long, long time. And as much as I hated 2016 Ghostbusters, a 3.5-hour cut of that movie might be interesting. It won't be good. Make no mistake about that. It's going to be probably even more disgustingly terrible than the mediocre pile of garbage that we got. That movie was meh. It was bad, but it was like, it wasn't so bad it's good bad. It was so bad, you're like, you know, like a dog on a nail sort of thing. You're like, all right, you know, whatever. It's just not a good movie. But a 3.5-hour cut of that movie could be something worth checking out and then also tearing into. I'll be fair on that front. I like to joke that I made more money talking about Ghostbusters than Sony made with actually releasing Ghostbusters. And I say that because they're look at the Box Office Mojo here. It had a $229 million take home on a budget of $144 million before advertising. So before marketing, it only brought in $229 million, which is not going to be considered quote-unquote profitable for Sony Pictures. In fact, I believe Paul Feig himself actually had said that the film hits $400 million worldwide, then that would be considered profitable, and then that would be considered something that would then be kind of sequel worthy. We've heard that thrown around for a long time. It didn't do that. So much so that even when the film came out on home video, Paul Feig did say that for all of you Holtzman fans out there, be sure to buy the Blu-ray if you want to see a sequel, because they were also trying to indicate how good it would do on home video as a way to, again, go back to Sony and get them to throw out the $150 million or whatever it's going to take for a sequel. And instead, Sony went back and said, no, why don't we go back to the drawing board and actually go and do a third movie, which is what the fans want. And now that the Snyder Cut has been greenlit, Ghostbusters, Afterlife is in the can. It's supposed to come out here pretty soon, not till next year now, unfortunately. We know that fan movements and fan discussions can actually push these things forward. It can actually push these conversations forward with studios. So I don't want to see a sequel to Ghostbusters 2016, but I have said that I do believe Sony is trying to find a way to merge the two together. I think Ivan Reitman is trying to find a way to merge the two together. And I say this because of IDW Comic Books having written a comic that did merge the two of them together at Comic-Con, I believe it was 2017. you had Ivan Reitman talking about Ghostbusters 2016 and that he liked the movie, that he liked the girls, and they were talking a lot about the comic book crossover. And to me, that always indicated that the idea was to find a way to merge the two universes together. And the movie 2016 is what I'm referring to here, I would say did well enough to warrant having Kate McKinnon as Holtzman come back over, or maybe, you know, Leslie Jones as Patty to come back over. Aaron and Abby, Melissa McCarthy and Kristen Wiig, they're not going to be coming over at all. They're done. Kristen Wiig, I believe, hated it. There was all those reports that she didn't like the movie. She felt ostracized and everything. However, but let's kind of talk about what this 3.5 hour cut would be, because I don't think it would get the same love that the movie got, the 74% certified fresh on Forgotten Tomatoes. You know, this is a bad one, you guys. This is a real bad one here. The 74% off of 380 reviews is just eh. And Sony really touted that as being a thing, by the way. They were like, oh, no, it's big. They put that in their advertising and all that jazz. But let's talk about here what to potentially expect from this. Would it be a better movie? The answer to that is no. The core story, we knew about the core story when the email hacks happened from Sony back in 2014, when the pitch Paul Feig sent to Amy Pascal leaked online, that ultimately was the movie. That was eventually confirmed by an insider who saw an early screening of it and broke it down beat for beat on Reddit. That actually ended up being legitimate. So we know that the story, that the core story was terrible. So you have to ask yourself, what is this 3.5 hour cut? What could it potentially be? Well, the original finished cut of the movie, the first assembly cut, my mistake, the first assembly cut of the film was 4 hours and 15 minutes, and then they trimmed that down to a lean, and I'm air quoting that, a lean 3 hours and 30 minutes. And then from there, they trimmed it down an additional 90 plus minutes to get it underneath 2 hours. Well, if you go and you watch the movie, you can kind of see where these extras popped in. And if you've seen the extended edition, which I don't recommend because it's actually worse than the theatrical, you can see what they wanted to add in. And also Paul Feig's shooting style is why everything was so long. And that's true. The way he shot that movie is it wasn't like he had a script and he followed the script. He had bullet points, and he would then have the actors ad-lib everything multiple times in order to get the right take. There's a scene in the movie where they just kind of plant a camera on a tripod, point it at Kate McKinnon, and have her do all of this weird dancing around the room, playing with, you know, with flame and everything else, you know, these welding burners, whatever they're called, torches. And then while they do a reverse shot showing Kristen Wiig, just kind of like watching her and like, oh, okay, you know, but you can tell that they just kind of pointed it at Kate McKinnon and said, go. And then Kate McKinnon just did whatever, improv'd whatever for however long that scene went on, which felt like a damn eternity because the movie was so damn bad. And that's how they shot the movie. They shot it improv style, like Anchorman, and a lot of the other ways that Paul Feig directs his movies is by just having the actors kind of show up, say what they want to say, and then they go and they cut it together in post-production. It's a really loosey-goosey approach, but the idea there is to put funny people, comedians, who are very quick-witted to see what they come up with on the fly and have it still progress the story forward. It failed with Ghostbusters because this is not an improv-based comedy. This is based off of an original 1984 working man blue-collar comedy. It was a blue-collar film wrapped around a spiritual paranormal storyline that worked out pretty well, and that's one of the reasons why people loved it, is it played it straight. The comedy comes from the characters living in this world and reacting in this world as if it is real. So they play it all straight. We as the audience interpret that and we laugh. None of that was in Ghostbusters 2016. Not a damn thing of it was in Ghostbusters 2016. It was just a mess of a movie. 3.5 hours is not something I think would save it. At the same time, because I support Zack Snyder and I support his artistic vision, if Paul Feig believes that his most complete artistic vision of Ghostbusters 2016 was that 3.5 hour cut, then I think it would be hypocritical of me to not come out and support it. That doesn't mean it's going to be good. That doesn't mean it's going to be it's make up for what happened. But no, it would allow me to sit there and waste, and I will say it, waste 3.5 hours of my one life on this planet watching something that will probably be so inanely terrible in order to talk to you about it so you don't have to. You guys would get enjoyment off of my pain. That is why I also support it, because it would be kind of funny to see how bad it truly is in a longer form. But I still, if he, that's his vision, that's what should be put out there. I support the artists and the artist's intent, even if I think the actual content is garbage and terrible and everything else. There's a difference between me and other people when it comes to supporting these sort of things. I want to see artists' visions, even if I didn't like the final product the first time around. So with that, I leave it to you, your thoughts, your opinions. Let me know down in the comments below. This should be a fun one. I really hope you guys made it to the end. Type in Ghostbusters in the chat if you guys did. I will talk to you all later. Have yourself a great day. Thank you again for watching, and peace out. Support the channel through Patreon. Support the channel through Patreon. Yo, you got to download us with the channel through Patreon. yeah, man. Just, yo, let me throw down some fresh, fat beats to pimp the Patreon. Yeah. What's up, dog? Pimp it. Yeah, that's right.